So it's been a while. You have an AC unit. You guys are quite pampered. You guys are lucky. My name is Abdullah Bait, and I am the Managing Director of Raffles Global Education Services. Plus, I'm also the Training Center Manager for the Andalusia Training Center. Have you heard of Andalusia?
Yes.
Yeah? Great. Before I begin, today I'm extra happy. Number one, because I'm back to school, back at my second home, and talking to my own brothers and sisters. Number two, if you tell me what's number two, I'll give you a chocolate.
I'm
imagining one. Wow, that was CBG. But that doesn't mean that I'm not going to take my job. Like, in another case, petroleum, chemistry, chemical engineering, chemistry. As long as chemistry, I can do it. I finished CBG, I finished from 6. Gladly, I did okay. I'm not going to tell how much I got, but I did okay.
Yeah.
I was not qualified to go straight into the university that I wanted. Okay? I graduated from Monash University, Malaysia, with biotechnology. You wonder if I have technology, I have some chemical engineering side. When I was doing pre-university, and then I started looking into chemical engineering. I wish someone told me more about it earlier, what they have, what's the courses, the subjects you do. So when I opened chemical engineering, I saw the subjects that was offered in the university, Monash. There's a lot of physics and mathematics. I got worried. I said, chemical engineering, chemistry, why physics and mathematics?
Afternoon, everyone. Barizemu. Assalamu alaikum. You all doing well?
Yes.
You enjoyed the presentation conducted by Mr. Abdullah and Ms. Nawal?
Yes.
Sasa-san. So I'll begin with one statement, and then I'll ask you, what did you understand by that statement? Marks don't determine you. What did you understand? Sorry?
There's more to life than just your grades.
There's more to life than just your grades. So you get a free copy of my book because you gave a wonderful answer. But the chocolate and the guitar. But let's be honest, the chocolate was more worth, right?
We shall see.
I would always choose chocolate over books. Okay, anybody else? Yes, sir?
Marks do determine you because you need CCC for the university.
So marks do determine you?
But they don't define you.
Okay. By the way, he participated in the public speaking program, and guess what his subject was? Love.
What was his second subject?
And his second subject was Valentine's Day. So well done to him. Okay, so marks don't determine you, neither do they define you. If you listen to Muzamil, he says marks do determine you, but they don't define you. There are a lot of people who fear failure. Failure in life. I'm not promoting failure or saying, you know, don't take things seriously and then end up failing. But there are certain times where you'll fail. Am I right or no?
Yes.
You will fail. Maybe you get A's, you know, in your entire report card. But maybe in your relationship you fail. Right? Maybe taking part in
I was never good at
guess which subject I wasn't good at. Math. I was never good at math. So you should never fear failure. So there's an article published by the Business Insider. You've heard of this news website? Business Insider is also a magazine. So there's an article and it talked about people who failed initially but succeeded eventually. Number one, name number one, Oprah Winfrey. You've heard of Oprah Winfrey?
Yes.
Who's Oprah Winfrey? The first?
First female black American television.
Yeah, the first female African American to be a television host. Any more detail on Oprah Winfrey, who she is? She's a multi-billionaire. What? Repeat after me. Multi-billionaire. Her net worth, billions. In fact, Oprah Winfrey, there are rumors that she might run for president in 2020.
I wish.
Highly unlikely because she said she won't run. But if she does, she has a high chance of winning the elections. So Oprah Winfrey, a candidate for the presidency, and her approval rating is extremely high, higher than the president himself. So Oprah Winfrey, guess what? Initially, when she was a host, she was fired. She's a star in television. She's what? A star. But initially what happened? She was fired from her first television channel. She was fired. They said that, you know, you're not creative, you're not innovative, you know, we're getting low ratings because of you, so you're fired. So Oprah Winfrey also struggled initially. Therefore, when you struggle in life, don't say, I will never succeed, I will never go. And you say, no, I'm now 20 years. There are some youth who say, I'm 20, how can I succeed? I've always done terrible in my exams, so how will I pass in life? How many of you have heard of Colonel Sanders? You don't know Colonel Sanders? Who's Colonel Sanders?
The owner of KFC.
Yeah, the owner of Kentucky Fried Chicken, KFC. Around from God's way, please. I wish I brought a coupon from KFC. I would have given it to you.
Anytime.
So now Colonel Sanders, would you like to hear his journey?
Yes.
Colonel Sanders. So Colonel Sanders, he lost his father. His father came back home with a very minor disease, fever. You just eat Panadol and you get cured, right? You go to the doctor prescribes the medicine and you're fine. He only had fever and he passed away, his father. He started making food at the age of 7 because he didn't have anyone in the house to cook. So he started cooking at age
7.
He started working at the age 10. How many of you here started working when you're 10 years old? Like serious work, not school work. Huh? Don't say I was doing my homework at age 10. Nobody, right? Even right now, majority here don't work. Maybe they part-time, but full-time, earning for your family. Age 10, he started working. And then 1902, his mother got married to another man, and that man was a dreadful human being, a terrible person. He mistreated Colonel Sanders, and they never got along. The stepfather and Sanders, they never got along. So until this time, he's still suffering, he's still struggling with life. Sarah, are you all getting me?
Yeah.
He is still struggling. Age 66, he has not achieved anything in life. He says, I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to commit
suicide.
So he says, I'm going to kill myself, but I'll write my will. You know, it's mandatory, it's compulsory to write a will. So I'll write a will and imagine. But then when he was writing his will, he said, no, why should I write my will? Why can't I write my dreams and ambitions on this paper? I'm 66. Maybe I'll live for a few more years. Maybe I'll achieve my dreams. So he says, no problem. I'll write my dreams and I'll accomplish those dreams. He borrowed $87. How much? $87. And with that $87, he would go door to door. Imagine the owner of KFC. He would knock at people's houses and buy my chicken, buy my fries. Come on. The taste is unparalleled. People would buy from him. Eventually, he earned so much money that he was able to build a company, the Kentucky Fried Chicken. Today, we have the Kentucky Fried Chicken all over the globe, all over the world. But when did he start achieving his goals? When did he start determining that I will prosper in life, I will succeed? Age, which age? He achieved his dreams, accomplished his vision when? When he was 87, he became a multimillionaire. Age? You are never late to start. Therefore, I'd like to thank Mr. Abdullah for counseling us. There was a free consultation to all of us. They do what you're good at. And it's never late to accomplish your dreams. So a round of applause for Mr. Abdullah. We are very grateful. So repeat after me. Never despair.
Never despair.
Ah, what a big joke. I know it's late. I know you have... Shabanian, Shaban, oye, Shaban,
oye,
Shaban, oye, Shaban, oye, Shaban,
oye,
Shaban, oye, Shaban,
oye,
Shaban, oye, story, and then I give my own personal example because people think I haven't failed in life, so I'm going to tell you about my failures. This is the only once I spoke at GC. So how many of you have heard of Eric Shigongo? I'll give a local example now. Eric Shigongo, anyone? Who is Eric Shigongo?
He's an author.
He's an author, okay. Yeah. He's a public speaker. I like your guesses, man. Are you ever? But this is your second book. You came for my lunch too. Say, I used to. Yes. Ah, yes. Safi, Sana. A round of applause for the answers, please. Round of applause. So he was super dumb in school. Super dumb. He has written books, How to Move from Poverty to Success. Right? He writes 26 ways whereby you can accomplish your dreams. This guy who has written books today, they are sold everywhere. He was completely dumb in school. Let me give you an example. So he went to class one day and the teacher said, why didn't you come yesterday to school? So Eric Shigongo said, Mwalimu nilikuwa na malazi. Malazi. When you say I am sick in Swahili, what do you say? Maradhi. What is malazi? Huh? Leave. What is malazi? Because malazi also has a meaning. Yeah,
so like accommodation.
Yeah, so basically, what the teacher thought is like, I was sleeping. Nilikuwa na malazi. I was in bed. So the teachers, they punished him because they thought he's making a mockery of them. So his name, from Eric Shigongo, people started calling him malazi. You know, sometimes you make one mistake and people start taunting you with that mistake.
Yes.
So your name forever remains malazi, malazi. Are there any examples here?
Yes.
Who?
Helium.
Helium. What do they call you? Kiduka. Do you mind it or do you not mind? Una mind it?
No,
I need that. Okay, hi. Okay, sawa. So what were they calling Eric Shigongo?
Malazi.
That Malazi fellow today is one of the most influential people in Tanzania. He has authored multiple books in Swahili and in English. You can say he is a billionaire right now in Tanzania. So Eric Shigongo, who was not very good at school, succeeded in life. So, do not fear failure. Repeat after me. Do not
fear failure.
Last story. You want to hear the last story?
Yes.
Sure?
Yes.
Dizzy Mawai?
No.
Shaaban Mawai?
Oye.
Almis Oye?
No.
Hi, Russell's Global Oye?
Oye.
Louder than Shaaban?
Yes.
See. Okay, so I had a dream. This is my personal dream. Not that type of dream. Not for the country, for myself. So what was my dream? You want to hear my dream, everyone?
Yes.
My dream was simple. I never wanted to do this. I did it. I never wanted to author my book. Alhamdulillah, I did 4 books. I never wanted to give a TEDx talk. I gave a TEDx talk. All these things happened by accident. I was like, let me just author my book, and it happened. I never wanted to do a book launch. I was told you should do a book launch. I did it. It was a success. I never wanted to do all those things. I wanted one very simple thing in life. Very simple. I wanted to be president of the Aga Khan Tizima Secondary School. Student Council. Very simple. I had a very deep love and connection with my school. That's why whenever people say, Tizima is not a good school, I always start arguing with them. I'm like, you study there? No. So, again, build a strong connection with your school. If you are just my dream of Shaaban,
to be a member.
President of the Student Council, not the school itself, the Student Council. And I knew, with my popularity in school, that I was winning this election. Very easily. In the country, maybe people don't know me, but in school I was getting along with everybody. I would give speeches, I would joke around, so I knew I was winning. Yes.
Basically talking about my life,
man. He's popular too, huh?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, sour. So I, again, I said I'm ready for president. Sour? Sawa,
yeah.
I get an email from 2 teachers. Even the teachers were looking for that. I wonder how it just. I got an email from 2 teachers. And I was told that because my health was bad, my health was really deteriorating. And for 1 whole month, I didn't go to school. I went to various doctors in Tanzania. I visited Harden, Dr. Karim. I visited Dr. Songal. I was like, what's going on, man? I'm having trouble with breathing. I can't even go to school. As soon as I go to school, my mood is off. People are like, Ejaz, how come today you haven't said a word? Like, people know I'm very talkative. They're like, Ejaz, what's going on? I don't know. I'm just having trouble with breathing. So the teacher sent me an email that, Ejaz, because of your health, we have no not doubt on your ability and capacity to run for president, but because of your health, you will not run for president. That was a failure, right? It was a failure because I wanted to be president. I get an email, and that was the worst day of my life. People are like, Ejaz, you have done a lot of things. What is this nonsense Zizima presidency that you're crying for? I'm like, no, I always wanted to do something for my school. So this was my dreams shattered. What? Shattered. I don't normally joke about this. In order to run for election, you need to have a selection. And I was not given that selection. Sawa, and I was very upset. Like, I was enraged. I was like, I'll go to school on Monday and I'm going to fire all these teachers. Who do you think they are? Then my parents calmed me down. Even they were upset. In fact, they called the teachers. Like, what's wrong? Other teachers have faith in Ejaz. He's going to do work as usual. And he will be fine. So they said, no, you know, he needs to focus on academics because he's missed a lot. Why did I want to become president? One simple reason. I wanted to allow students to get exposure. To get
exposure.
So I was thinking that, okay, I haven't accomplished this dream of mine, which was being president. But I have another dream. I want students to, you know, express themselves. I wanted to build a platform. I gave a TEDx talk. I was like, I can't organize another TEDx talk in Zizima, but I can do a public speaking program. So I thought of MWO, Zizima with Orators. But I'm no longer president, so how can I do it? I went to my teachers, like, is it possible? They said, yes. You can still organize a public speaking program, MWO from Zizima, even though you're not president. And one dream of mine was, you know, shattered. But that doesn't mean all your dreams will be shattered. I was able to do the Zizima with Orators, and it was a big success. Therefore, moral of my story, if you are unable to accomplish one dream, that doesn't mean you can't accomplish other dreams. Because that one dream, when the door is shut, that doesn't mean all the doors in the room are shut. You can go through other doors and accomplish other dreams in life. You have to understand your purpose. If you say today that I want to become a doctor and become a millionaire, maybe you are not meant to be a doctor, Baba. Maybe you are meant to be a lawyer and still become a millionaire. Sawa?
Yes.
Imeleweka?
Yes.
Okay, asante sana. Thank you very much.